Hello, everybody, and welcome to the next Harvest Moon Let's Play for this channel. I want to introduce you all to a little game known as Grand Bazaar. Despite playing this one quite a bit on my own in the past, I feel like there's a lot that I can still learn. And I feel like I've never really unlocked this game's full potential by understanding all of the mechanics, and I really want to be able to do a really efficient run of this game. It's been a while since I played, but I figured that this was the perfect opportunity to do all of those things while also showing it to all of you. So hopefully I'll be able to provide a more streamlined experience than what I had playing in my own time. We'll go right ahead and dive on in. You can see that I have been doing quite a bit of practice. So because this is an older Harvest Moon game from the DS era, your only two options are male and female, and you sort of are forced to pick between one or the other. It unfortunately isn't a situation where we're going to be able to date whoever we want. So because I'm playing as a female on my practice file, we're gonna go ahead and choose a male farmer, and that way we'll be able to see all of the heart events, and it will allow me to provide all of that content for you all. And just a quick fun fact before we move on is that the canon names for the two protagonists of this game are Hansel and Gretel, if you can believe that. We will obviously be picking a different name. Far away from the city lies a small town known for its gentle, soft wind. The sound of windmills greets the citizens of the town each morning. You can actually see the wind in motion. You've got some windmills moving, you've got some flower petals in the breeze. Everything is lush and green. It's a beautiful little scene so far. Can't wait to see more. Ah, we're finally here. This is your new home, Zephyr Town. Sorry, what was your name again? We're just gonna go with ye old classic that I use all the time. Short and sweet. What a fine name. Now then, when were you born? I don't recall birthdays really being all that important in this game, so I think it's safe to just pick whatever day that you want. And it's probably best if your birthday lands somewhere between Monday and Friday, but even if I pick the closest thing to my actual birthday, I know that this isn't going to be on a weekend, so this calendar isn't really accurate for what day of the week your birthday is actually going to fall on, and I really don't think it matters. Ah, the town is quite a sight that time of year. My name is Felix, by the way. Oh, well. Pleased to make your acquaintance. I'm the mayor of this humble town. I'm glad to see young folks like you getting involved in farming. It's great to have you here. Oh, why, thank you. It's good to be here. Take a look. This is the entrance in the town as well as the site of our bazaar. Once a week, the citizens in town set it up to attract visitors. Many things are sold and the customers always leave happy. The weekend market is really popular around where I live, and it's kind of neat to go because you can find a lot of handmade stuff, usually. Yes, unfortunately your face says it all. The bazaar used to be a much grander event. Oh, you don't say. Our once world-famous bazaar has now just become a small market. If things continue like this, the bazaar might even close for good. But as the mayor, I can't stand idly by and watch this happen. I must do something. I'd like you to open a store at our bazaar. You could sell products from your farm. And the better your products, the more you'll be able to sell. You'll earn fame as a great farmer, and you'll be helping the town. Isn't that a great idea? You'll help us out, right? So, unlike most Harvest Moon games, the entire purpose of this game is to make money and to expand the bazaar. So, capitalism, basically, it has a very unique premise from some other games. So yeah, we're gonna dive right in and offer to help. Fantastic, I knew you would say yes. Remember, everyone in town is counting on you to help us. Now then, let me show you where you'll be staying. Yes, please do. For helping them out, we're just given a farm. Some beautiful land. I would love to just walk into a city and be handed over an old farm with, you know, a fully built house on it and everything. So we need to name our farm. I am really terrible with coming up with names. I'm just very, very uncreative. And you're limited in this game to only having 6 characters, which is just really not a lot. I think I'll call my farm Green, which I know is extremely boring, but it ties into the theme of money and also kind of to a theme of, you know, farming and nature and whatnot. We're just gonna go with that. That's a great name, fitting for such a fine farm. Why don't you try moving around? So he's gonna go over some of our controls here. We can use the L button to switch between walking and running as we move around with the control stick. And we also have the ability to jump using the A button. So we're gonna go test all of that out, and then we'll go and speak to Felix when we're done. The timer is frozen right now because we're in tutorial mode, so this is a good chance for you to sort of check out the farm if you want. And he did talk about toggling between walking and running, which is what I'm doing now. And that's actually a hugely important mechanic in this game. We'll elaborate a little bit more on that later, but there are going to be certain situations where you don't want to be running at full speed. But you can see we have this nice field over here. It's actually a pretty generous starting field. This is pretty big. We've got ourselves a watering hole. There's a windmill over here. And then we could also test out the jumping function. And the jumping actually gets quite a bit of mileage in this game. You're gonna be surprised with how much you actually will use jumping. We also have a pen for some future animals. And then we just have this big empty space behind our house. So we'll go back and talk to Felix. And fair bit of warning, the beginning tutorial of this game is pretty long, so bear with me. We'll just speak to him and kind of get things moving along here. The B button usually indicates people that you can talk to, things that you can examine, etc. And he's gonna have us demonstrate using the B button to examine items. So we use the B button to pick up items. There's a huge icon above items, so it's pretty unlikely that you're gonna forget how to do that. And if you press the B button while you have an item in your hands, you'll throw it. If you press the Y button, you'll put it in your bag. He actually doesn't allow us to throw it at this time, just to see what that would look like. So we're sort of just forced to tuck that branch away into our bag. And then to check our bag, we're going to press the X button. You can do many things while checking your bag. You can move the cursor and select things with A, and we can toss things away to just get rid of them permanently. We can drop things on the ground. Holding an item is what holds it above our heads, and then we can also equip things from this menu as well. And then when you're finished, you would press the B button to close your bag. And it's sort of the closest thing to a pause menu, because you don't have that in this game. So you'll want to go into the bag if you sort of need to pause the game and just take a bit of a break. That's the basics about how to use your bag. And then finally, we actually get to go inside the house now, which is nice. This is your house. And the first thing he's gonna do is show us the storage room, which is another really important aspect of this game. This is the storage room. Go have a look inside. It's also fairly obvious because it has that big chest icon beside it, so you'll know where your storage room is, and we use it to hold items when our bag is full. Fruits, milk, and other perishable items will last longer in storage, and you're gonna know if an item will perish if it has a freshness level, which we'll learn a little bit more about later. And just like our bag, it functions the same. Same controls, and you would also just press the B button to get out of here when you're ready. Now, time is not paused when you are in storage normally as you play through the game, so you just have to be very mindful of that, that the clock will still run as you're sorting things. And our two items that we have, a branch and a rock, you'll notice that they have a star level. This game also deals with a quality system, so items are ranked from 0.5 of a star all the way up to 5 stars. And items like branches and rocks, they don't have a freshness level at all, which means that these items don't degrade in quality and they won't go rotten. So items like this, if you are able to hold them, are best kept in your bag. And that's about everything you need to know. There is one other thing I'd like to show you. This basket here is very useful. So he says, but I never use this thing. Anything you put in here is automatically sent to storage. If you toss an item in, it will be sent to storage automatically. But if your storage is full, you can't add items. What will happen is you'll throw an item, and it will go in the basket, but then it will bounce out. And the good thing about the basket is that it is portable, so it is something that you can move around, which some people might find useful. Well, I'm sure you're pretty tired by now. Just stand next to your bed and press the B button when you want to go to sleep. If you'd like, check out the bookshelf or the kitchen before you go to bed. And then we also have a calendar that we can look at. Now, there's quite a few things in our house that Felix didn't mention that I think are kind of useful. And we also can't go into our animal area right now, which just hasn't been covered at all. But you can see that we have a very spacious and empty house, but for one person, this place is pretty damn big. So he did talk about looking at the bookshelf, and this is where we would view all of our assets. So anything to do with money will be here, and anything collection-wise, our friendship levels, there's just a lot of really, really useful stuff. Any kind of statistic that you'd want to know about really is here. So this is kind of a nice thing to check time and time again, just to kind of see where you're at and to keep track of your finances. He also mentioned the calendar, which is hanging in between the tub and this doorway, and I think that this game's calendar is really, really well laid out. So you can check all sorts of things on here, and I definitely recommend checking the calendar often. It's just a very easy to understand little legend with all of these different icons. You have stars, which will indicate a festival. Little birthday cakes will indicate somebody's birthday. And then you also will be shown what day the bazaar is. Bazaars take place on either Saturday or Sunday, so sometimes it's good to look ahead and figure out what day of the week it's gonna be. And then you can also go through and look at the entire year, which I like. Sometimes in these games they don't let you look ahead, but I think it's nice to sort of look ahead because you can plan for future festivals or how far away somebody's birthday is if you have a gift you really think that they'd like but you're short on storage or something, say. So I do recommend checking your calendar as often as you can. And then through this doorway, he talked about our kitchen. We have this massive kitchen. You can see that our storage is also attached up here. And I'm not going to go into cooking. It's very, very similar to the Sunshine Islands system. I think the cooking system was kind of used for a lot of DS games. You can cook without a recipe to freely choose what you want and make food that way, which is riskier because you could end up with a failed dish. Whereas if you cook from the recipe, you already know it and you'll be able to get the desired result. And then you will gather recipes if you make food and it turns out to be a recipe that you don't already have. And then we can also customize. So we can unlock recipes by buying dishes from the cafe, which I'll go a little bit more into detail about later on. And for now, we only have one recipe. We are going to get some serious mileage out of the one recipe that we have. But we're not going to be too focused on cooking right now otherwise. And there's also a few other things in our house that he hasn't mentioned, but that we don't get to talk about because we don't have access to them at the moment, such as our bathtub, our bathroom, and this lovely vase down here that we can fill with flowers. These are all things that will help us with our stamina later on as we go through. And then last but not least, once you're ready to end things for the day, you're pooped out, you're ready to call it a day, you would examine your bed. One really important thing to remember about this game is that you do not have the ability to use a journal to save freely. A huge pet peeve of mine, I hate when this restriction is in place. You can only save your game at the end of a day. It forces you to go to bed if you save your game. And I think that really is sort of a frustrating thing, because if you make a mistake or you want to go back and try something again, then you have to repeat an entire day, which is really just a lot of time lost. I don't have to worry about that because I'm playing on the emulator, thank goodness, but if you were playing this on the cartridge, it's a real drag. So make sure that you've done absolutely everything that you want to do before you turn in for the day so that you can save your game. Whew, okay. So, like I said, this game, the tutorial is a little bit long and this first episode is a little bit slow, just going over all of the basics. Once we wake up tomorrow morning, Felix is going to have just a little bit more tutorial for us, but we should be able to get to some playing tomorrow and actually get out there and see what this game is all about. So bear with me, folks. It will get a little bit more exciting from here on out, I promise. We'll actually get to some gameplay and seeing what's outside the farm, seeing what the town's really all about. So I hope that you're all looking forward to seeing more of this. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know if this is one that you've played or one that you've never heard of before. And hopefully you will continue on with me in my journey delving back into Grand Bazaar. Thank you all so very much for watching, and I hope that I will see you next time.